The medical procedure we're about to take you through is not new. It was first performed back in the 30s, and in a number of places in this country, it's become almost routine, but it is still no less remarkable. A hole in his head is about that operation called a pallidotomy, a procedure used to ease the agonies of Parkinson's disease, the brain disorder that affects millions of people, mainly, but not necessarily, older people. The operation is not a cure, and it is not for every Parkinson's patient. With the help of British Broadcasting Corporation cameras, which stayed with one patient before, during, and after the surgery, Morley Safer went to Bristol, England, to witness the minor miracle that happened to a man named Fred Amphlett.
I think eating has become one of the real curses of Parkinson's disease.
Fred Amphlett is 48. He's had Parkinson's disease since he was 35. First one side of his body, then his entire body.
And the more conscious you become, the worse it gets, as you will so rightly see.
This is the best that drugs can do for him. His mind is alert, his body an agony of lurching, uncontrollable movement. To give Fred Amphlett this amount of control, barely able to control his body, he must be given 20 injections a day and at least 10 pills every day.
Thank you very much.
Bye.
Most of these movements, you see, with this sort of jigging about, is caused through the drug. Not Parkinson's, patient is a side effect of the drug. And this is where the worry comes in again. You're in a catch-22 situation, in which you take more and more drugs every day to combat the illness, and gradually the side effects outweigh the benefits of the drug.
Right.
If I don't take the drugs, I just come to a stop.
To add to the torment, Fred's a man who is very active in his job on the Bristol docks and in a number of sports. Now, he is totally dependent on his wife, Jill.
He's very conscious when he's out of people watching him, and you know, people usually frown usually at him because he looks as though he's drunk. Because he has no walking stick or, you know, things like that, there's no prop to say, you know, this man's ill.
This man, once so active, he played rugger, he sailed, he built his own furniture. He is now reduced to this. Without drugs, he's a virtual zombie.
You are, love. Sorry I took so long. There you go.
In Parkinson's disease, the part of the brain that allows for easy movement shuts down. The body becomes frozen. When he's like this, Fred cannot eat or read or even reach for a drink. The drugs break that spell, but produce something almost as hellish. Fred has reached the end of the line as far as any further medication is concerned. His only hope is an operation called a pallidotomy.
We are offering a surgical treatment where we destroy or neutralize an overactive area of the brain.
Dr. Stephen Gill is a consulting neurologist at the French A Hospital in Bristol, one of a new breed of European and American surgeons who've been perfecting an old procedure using all the technical tools of the 90s.
Surgery is always considered as a last resort. You don't offer people surgery at the beginning of their disease, because surgery always carries some degree of risk. And medical treatment has made a huge difference to Parkinson's disease. And it's really those patients that have failed treatment that can be helped by this sort of operation.
I think that would be a fair statement.
The theory is that by destroying a very small part of one overactive area of the brain called the globus pallidus, Fred could be freed of both the frozen and writhing episodes.
Okay.
Because Fred has reached the limit of what drugs can do, Dr. Gill has decided he's a perfect candidate for surgery. And finally, the day. Doctors have reduced his medication to a point where he is not quite frozen, where he can still be responsive. The first step is an MRI, magnetic resonance imaging. Images of the brain that will become the surgeon's map. Fred was the most severely stricken patient the surgical team had operated on. Dr. Gill decided he must hit targets on both sides of the brain.
What are the parameters you have when you're working on trying to reach a spot the size of what, a pea or a
kernel of corn? It's a petit pois, I would say.
A small pea.
Yes, it's about, it's a lesion, generally about 5 millimeters in diameter.
You use the word lesion. What exactly does that mean?
A lesion is a small volume of tissue that you destroy.
Literally burn it up.
You burn a small volume of tissue.
First, a metal frame is attached. It will both keep him still and act as part of a mathematical instrument, giving the doctor precise external reference points. Then a CAT scan is done, which shows the position of the frame in relation to the skull. The frame are those white dots on the screen. The pictures are then matched to the MRI images of Fred's brain. Together, they allow the surgeon to calculate the exact position of the target, the globus pallidus. Anyway, that's the theory.
This is the globus pallidus, which is seen on the image, and I'll be passing a needle down to this target, and really we have to be accurate to within a millimeter, otherwise going too deep by a millimeter will damage his vision. And if I go too much towards the midline by a millimeter, then it could get a paralysis. I don't think there's any operation that you would see quite like this. This is an operation where the patient's awake and responding to you, and you make a lesion or you destroy a small volume of brain, and suddenly things change. It is really quite dramatic and emotional.
For the surgeon?
For the surgeon and the patient.